Hi everyone, in today's video I'd like to tell you something about what I've been working on during the last 2 months and some progress that I've made in some of my games since my last video in March, I think it was. So, first of all, I've actually been making some good progress on Hero or Villain Armageddon, which I'm still hoping will be finished in late 2023. Now, in March, the playthroughs were about 22,000 words, and currently in my last count did about 30,000 words. Now, this may not seem like a big increase, but of course behind this increase in 8,000 words is actually there's a lot of code and there's a lot of different options that you may not necessarily be choosing. So I'm actually quite pleased with where the game is now compared to where it was in March. And if you want to know more about the features of this game, please check my March 2023 video. Now, suffice to say that there will be multiple branching points here, so there are major points in the game at which you will be diverging, and there'll be some tough choices that you may have to make if you want to branch out at different points. So, quite pleased with where that is going, although I still have to also code a lot of the side missions, etc. And Tiffany, who makes almost all of the illustrations for my games, has also been working in the interior artwork for the game. And here you can see one of the characters that you'll be meeting, and then some of the scenes and other aliens that you'll be meeting during the game. So I'm quite happy with how this is taking shape. Now, I've also been working a little bit on my time with some of the times that I had on an extra quest for Raiders of Icepeak Mountains. Now, this Raiders of Icepeak Mountains is a fantasy RPG which is written in ChoiceScript. So I think this is probably, if not the only, maybe one of the only RPGs which has been actually written in ChoiceScript. It has leveling, it has you can choose multiple classes, like you can be a fighter, a wizard, etc. It seems to be one of my lesser known games, but I mean, if you haven't tried it, please try it out. And for those who've bought the game already, in the next week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, I'll be uploading a new version, and hopefully, in that new version there will be a new side mission where you'll be able to battle a manticore. So I've been working on that, for example, today, and I'm quite happy with that. So yeah, that is some new content for Raiders of Icepeak Mountains. And of course, I'm also trying to work on some extra side missions from some of my other games, and I have made also some progress on that. Now, in previous videos, I told you that Hero Villain Battle Royale, the card game, is already being printed, and I showcased this at the Tokyo Game Market a couple of weeks ago. I think people really enjoyed it. Several people bought the game. Of course, I made it. I would like to think myself it's also that it's very nice little game. It has sort of Russian roulette mechanisms similar to those found in Exploding Kittens. It has social deduction mechanisms as well, and you can actually buy it from the link below, and I'll be putting the link in this video below if any of you are interested in it. So it has new artwork that was exclusively made for this, and it has a lot of the characters that were present in Hero or Villain Battle Royale. So, and also on the back of that, I've actually been starting to make a new card game. I enjoyed the experience of making the first one. It allowed me to, you know, branch out and use my time differently, and sometimes, especially in the days when I'm not so inspired to write. So this one is called Fantasy Tavern Brawl, and it's more of a dexterity game by throwing cards and placing meeples on top of the cards and trying to take the meeples of other characters, of other players, off their cards, etc. Now, I'll be launching this in Kickstarter later this year. I'm currently still playtesting it. Anyway, those of you who are interested, please consider registering interest at the pre-launch Kickstarter page in the link here. And all this will do is, once the game is launched on Kickstarter, it will let you know whether you're interested in backing it. So please, you know, if you're interested in this kind of thing, please subscribe to this. And the artwork that you can see at the beginning of this video, it will be the cover of this game. Again, this is Tiffany that's made the artwork. So I'm quite happy with it. I think it looks fantastic. And that is enough for today. Obviously, if you like the videos that I'm making, if you want to know more about what's going on, please subscribe to them and then you'll be notified when I make new videos. So that is all. Thank you so much.